Every bearing should have a load on it. This can be a static or a dynamic load. It is important to know how big the load is and from which direction the load will be attached to the bearing. The P stands for pressure and can be calculated by dividing the load F, normally mentioned in the unit newtons, through the projected area. For the projected area of a bearing, we take the inside diameter of a bearing times the bearing length. That results in a surface pressure in newtons per square millimeters or MPa. So it is quite easy to calculate a surface pressure. In this case, we calculate the static bearing pressure. But of course, in most applications, there is also a movement, so a speed. By adding a speed, we will get a dynamic load. Here you see the different type of movements. You see a rotation, oscillation, and linear, and the formulas to calculate the velocity V. As you see, not a very difficult formula, UPMs times the diameters times V, and you divide it by 60 by 1000. That is to make to a unit of meters per second. We have calculated the surface pressure, P, and the velocity, V. We come to a PV value. You see it, an actual PV value gives an indication of the heat which occurs during running of a bearing in an application. When we have that PV value, we can check and compare that with a permissible PV value of different materials.